Thank you. Good evening, everyone. At this time, I'd like to invite our grads to the stage and the processional to begin.
Thank you.
grad class of 2023 from Harrison Trimble. I have a quick story. After last year's graduation, I went in, I was looking to buy a car. I was sitting down in the sales manager's office, and he said, Mr. Wilson, can I ask a question? I said, yes. He said, will you cry during this meeting? Okay. I thought that was kind of a strange question. I said, well, not unless you give me a really bad price. And he said, because I was at your graduation last night, and you cried an awful lot. So I promise I probably won't cry tonight, and he probably learned a lesson because I didn't buy a car from him. Good evening and welcome to our 2023 graduation ceremonies for Harrison Trimble High School. My name is Gary Wilson, and I'm proud to be the principal. I'd like to welcome our honored guests, our families, our friends, and our Trojan staff to tonight's proceedings. Tonight is a time to celebrate the amazing accomplishments of our grad class. Each student here traveled their own path to earn the right to graduate. I would like to take a moment to recognize the important contributions that others have played in the graduate success. Thank you to the parents and families who have an unconditional love for you and will watch the ceremonies tonight with their hearts full. Thank you to all the coaches, mentors, and advisors who have helped and guide you along the way. Thank you to your elementary and middle school teachers who prepared you for high school and nurtured your love of learning along the way. Might be wrong. Finally, I'd like to thank the amazing staff of Harrison Trimble. Your passion for a student stands out, and you're a hero to many of our students. Right now, I'd like to invite Elena Boudreau up to the stage to give the territorial acknowledgement, followed by 2023 grads Cameron Albert, Oliver Peters, Alexandra Reith, and Hope Wilson to sing O Canada.
Good evening. We would like to begin by acknowledging that the land on which we gather is the traditional unceded and unsurrendered territory of the Mi'kmaq peoples. This territory is covered by the treaties of peace and friendship, which Mi'kmaq and Wistakiak people first signed with the British Crown in 1725. The treaties did not deal with surrender of lands and resources, but in fact recognized Mi'kmaq and Wistakiak title and established the rules for what was intended to be a relationship between nations. We are grateful and honored to be on Mi'kma'ki, which is the name the Mi'kmaq give their land.
True page. sait porter l'épée, il sait porter la croix. Ton histoire est une épopée des plus brillants espoirs. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on God for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on God for thee.
Good evening. My name is Ryan Johnson. I'm vice principal and part of the admin team in Harrison Trimble. I'd like to begin this evening with introducing our greetings from our honorable guest. I'd first like to introduce our first speaker of the night, and I would like to welcome a greeting by Mr. Greg Turner, the MLA of Moncton South, to the stage, please.
Thank you very much. I'm honored to join you this evening as a proud graduate of Harrison Trimble and the member of the legislature for Moncton South. I want to share with you, it was 54 years ago this evening that I graduated from Trimble, and it's such a pleasure to be back here with all of you this evening and reliving those memories with you. I bring you greetings, best wishes, and good luck on behalf of the government of New Brunswick. I also bring thanks to all the families, friends, neighbors, and community who've supported our grads on their journey. You are graduating into a complicated, challenging, and uncertain world. Same as every graduating class that has come before you. The times and technology may change, but people don't. When people are making an extra effort to help out and show kindness, it lifts the spirits of everyone. I wish for you a life ahead filled with people trying to help out and showing kindness to you. Of course, that works both ways. I knew you were anxious to get on with the rest of your lives, just as we were in my graduating class of 1969. So I will conclude by once again wishing you well on behalf of the government of New Brunswick. Have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg. I would like to introduce our second speaker of the night, and I'd like to welcome a greeting by Mr. Brian Butler, counselor for Ward 3, to the stage, please.
Thanks, Ryan. Okay, so 5 pages of notes. Joke. First, I'd like to mention that is also, we're celebrating National Indigenous Peoples Day today. So, very, very important. To Mr. Wilson, administration, teachers, staff, parents, guardians, invited guests. But most of all, to the class of 2023 graduating from the Harrison Trimble High School. I bring greetings on behalf of Mayor Arnold, City Council, but also all the citizens of the City of Moncton. You know, it's a great goal to be able to accomplish what you have so far. Some will move away and for further their education, but we really do hope that you come back and help us grow this beautiful city as it's growing and growing and growing, and we would like for you to be part of it. So the last thing you need is a politician up here to read 5 pages, so I'm going to make it very short. My other career was, I was an old police officer. I don't think I was around when Greg was in high school. I think I might have been just a thought. You know, it's quite an accomplishment. You're going on to your next chapter in life, but I would give you just a little bit of advice from an old police officer. Go out tonight or tomorrow night or this weekend and enjoy yourself. This is a great accomplishment, very big accomplishment. But remember, this is only one chapter. There's lots more chapters in your life. So when you go tonight and you want to get together with your friends and your neighbors, and just remember this. If you're drinking or you're high, please, please do not drive. If you need a drive, call somebody that isn't drinking or high. Enjoy the rest of your life. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. I'd now like to introduce our third greeting of the night. I'd like to welcome Mr. Randy McLean, Superintendent for Anglophone East School District, to the stage, please.
Good evening. My name is Randy McLean. I was introduced as a superintendent, but I wear many hats. But before I begin, I'd like to thank and congratulate Mr. Turner. Thank you very much for your words this evening. I was born in 1969. Mr. Butler, thank you very much for bringing greetings. And Dominic Vautour, our district education council member who was responsible for Harrison Trimble, thank you very much for being here this evening. Mr. Wilson, your administrative team, I normally do not write speeches. And as a high school principal and a superintendent, I've given many high school graduation speeches. But tonight's particularly special for me and special for us. And if I pause, I apologize. As I said, I wear many hats. One of those hats is a teacher. One of those hats is a husband. One of those hats is an uncle, as Claire Forsyth graduates this evening. But the hat I'm the most proud of is Dad. Our youngest daughter, Sabrina, graduates this evening as a member of the Harrison Trimble 2023 graduating class, moved across the country in grade 12, and has been successful and has thrived in her new home. But it takes many people to do that. And I can only thank Mr. Wilson and his staff, the teachers, support staff, her friends, her coaches, and supports along the way that have made that happen. But that's not just my story and our story. That's each parent in this room, that's your story. And as a graduate, that is also your story. You are graduating at an amazing time. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom, it was the age of foolishness. You're graduating following a pandemic. This is the first year in your graduating in your high school career with some semblance of normalcy. Everything from class, you can now walk down any direction you'd like. You don't have to wear a mask, you can take part in activities, you can take part in class, there are not split shifts, you don't go every day and every other day. Also, there's been a return to extracurricular activities, walking randomly, and you've had the opportunity to see each other's faces as you cry and celebrate together. But there's also a time that in generations we have not witnessed. As we see through Truth and Reconciliation, today is Aboriginal Peoples Day, which was declared in 1996 by the Governor General Romeo LeBlanc. It is also Pride Month. And I would encourage each of you to take part, create a community where all of us feel safe, and all of us can take part, and all of us are accepted. While at the same time, you've been part of and witness to the Me Too movement, as well as Black Lives Matter. You have the opportunity to create the world you want. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. You are graduating an unprecedented time. Your choice, your path, the support you've received, the opportunities you have, and the education you've received is unparalleled. But your creativity, your passion, your empathy, your determination will determine the world we have. The world needs you. The community needs you. The world needs you, and we need you. We are at an exciting time. On behalf of the District Education Council, myself, it is an honor to be here this evening, but I have one final thought. Please remember, no matter where your journey takes you and the challenges you have before you, you can always come home. Your parents will open their homes. You can live in their basements for as long as you want. But greatness is a journey. May your journey be true and safe and filled with challenges and celebrations. But most of all, you have the opportunity to write it. Go forth, write your journey, write your greatness, make the world a better place, because you will. Thank you so much. Have a great evening.
Thank you, Mr. McLean. I'd now like to ask Mr. Wilson to come to the podium to give the principal's address.
Honored guests, family, friends, and educators, thank you for being here tonight to celebrate the graduating class of 2023. Our graduates represent the best of what it means to be Canadian. They are the most multicultural and inclusive group of students we have ever had at Harrison Trimble High School. Our 230 graduates come from 32 nations and speak 23 languages. Harrison Trimble is known throughout the city, district, and province as a school with an unparalleled sense of spirit and pride. However, I feel that our greatest strength as a school is that we strive to be inclusive to all of our students, regardless of race, gender, or religion. Are we perfect? No, we are far from perfect. But if we keep having those conversations, educate, and treat each other with kindness and respect, then we will continue to move the needle in a much more positive direction. When I was a high school student in this district, thank you, Mr. Turner, for saying when you graduated, because I didn't want to tell you I graduated in 82, but now it doesn't seem so bad. When I was a high school student in this district, our schools weren't multicultural. What we learned about other peoples and societies came from the books that we read, the things we saw on TV or movies, or what we heard from others. We did not have appreciation for the world outside of our province. It is a blessing to have so many students from different nations attend Harrison Trimble, and a privilege to see HTHS truly transform into a school where everyone is welcome. In 1963, Martin Luther King Jr. told us that he looked forward to the day when a person is judged by the content of their character rather than the color of their skin. In 2023, we need to expand our thinking to include a person's gender identity and religious affiliations. How you treat people, the grace you offer, the love you give, these virtues are what is truly important. Grads, your generation has the opportunity, ability, and the education needed to eliminate all forms of discrimination and bigotry. Perhaps that will be the best legacy of Gen Z, because the other rep you got, not so good. Today you graduate, and the way that the world looks at you starts to change. Gone are the childhood days of playing tag and Saturday morning cartoons. You are moving into a time in your life when you will be looked at as an adult, someone who is educated, makes good decisions, sets a positive example, and contributes to our society. As you enter this new stage of your life, I would ask that you reflect and think about the people in your lives who have set a positive example for you. These are the people that encouraged you when you were down, listened deeply to what you had to say, and helped guide you down the road to more success. Hillary Clinton said, "Parents are teachers, and home is a child's first and most important classroom." Congratulations to all the parents and guardians who have raised such wonderful young people. The greatest gift you can pass on to someone is instilling within them a foundation of love and kindness. Look to your family and friends that love and support you and appreciate all of the times they have had a profound impact on your life. Grads, many times you have heard me say, if no one has told you that they love you today, know that there is someone here that does. I first heard those words from one of my teachers, and as I grew to know this person and how they treated everyone that they came in contact with, I came to realize that she meant what she said. It was her actions that gave her words a deeper meaning. I want the grad class of 2023 to know that so many of our school staff feel that way about you, and I hope that this was expressed to you through their actions. As your principal, I'm blessed to collaborate with a staff of teachers, educational assistants, and support staff who genuinely care about your well-being. Their hearts are also full, having watched you grow into the young adults you are today. I hope that you take from them not only the lessons that they taught in the classroom, but the genuine care that they have for you and the sincere desire to see you become the best person you can be. Lastly, I would encourage you to appreciate the things in your life that are truly authentic. Your self-worth is not based on the number of likes you get on your social media platforms, nor does it rely on you becoming TikTok famous. That's why I took all your phones. The value of any person is based on what they do, what they say, and what they give back. Don't be fooled into thinking that every contribution has to have a dramatic effect on a large number of people. Most often, it is a small thing that has an impact on perhaps only one person, and that one person later passes on that same positive energy. Everyone striving for personal excellence, big or small, creates a tsunami of goodwill. I encourage you to talk to people face to face to get them to understand them better. When you disagree with someone, take exception to the idea they expressed rather than believing that because they disagree with you, that makes them a bad person. Take the time needed to find someone who will become special in your life and then build with that person a foundation that is unshakable. You began today as a Harrison Trimble student. And when you walk through those doors tonight, you will leave as an alumnus. As scary as the real world can be, we know that you're ready for it, and I hope you know how much our staff love being part of your lives for all of your years that you are at HTHS. HTHS. Oh, yes. And now, I'd like to invite up Cameron Salage, who is going to introduce our guest speaker for the evening.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson. Good evening, all. Our guest speaker tonight is a fellow Harrison Trimble High School graduate who attended our school from 2002 to 2006. During her time as a Trojan, she was a member of many sports teams, including girls field hockey, basketball, and volleyball, as well as the unofficial manager of the cheerleading squad. In addition to leading the student body as student council president, she won the Governor General's Bronze Medal for Academic Excellence and the Burks Medal for Leadership in Student Affairs. She graduated from Dalhousie University in 2010 with a Bachelor in Science with honors in microbiology and immunology. She was later a member of the inaugural class at Dalhousie Medicine, New Brunswick, graduating in the top 10% of her class in 2014. She then completed her residency training in obstetrics and gynecology at the IWK in 2019. She currently works as a staff obstetrician and gynecologist in Truro, Nova Scotia. She is delighted to be speaking to the graduating class of Harrison Trimble High School tonight. Please join me in welcoming our guest speaker, Dr. Brittany Black, to the stage.
More high tech than when I graduated. No one told me it was going to be live streamed. Congratulations, class of 2023. I'm honored to be speaking to you all tonight. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I know I'm not alone in saying just how very proud I am of each and every one of you. Look around this auditorium. It is filled with people who love you. To the teachers and family members in the audience, you should also be so proud of yourselves, as these students would not be here today without your support. Standing here today, the nostalgia is almost overwhelming. I'm immediately taken back to my own graduation. It seems like just yesterday, and I guess compared to some people who spoke tonight, it's kind of like yesterday. I was sitting on the stage at the Coliseum, wearing a maroon cap and gown, probably the same gown that one of you is wearing today. Surrounded by my friends, we were all so proud of ourselves. We felt like we knew everything, and yet we really knew nothing. But overall, we were just so excited for our futures to begin. Graduation is such a special day. It is a result of all your hard work over the past 4 years. It's the first day of the rest of your lives. It feels surreal to be standing up here giving your commencement speech. In some ways, it feels kind of silly. How am I qualified to be standing up here? What advice could I possibly pass along to you when I'm still trying to figure out how to be an adult myself? But it has been 17 years since I graduated from Trimble. You were all literally babies when my friends and I stood in your place. Surely I've learned something worthwhile in that time, something that I can pass along to help you as you prepare to start this next chapter. For better or worse, the world has changed a lot since I graduated. However, there are some truths about life that are timeless. I can't take credit for these words of wisdom I'm going to share. I didn't come up with them. These are just phrases and concepts that have stuck with me over the years. I wish I'd learned a lot of these sooner. And to be honest, I'm still trying to put many of them into practice today. So here we go. Number one, shake it off. I'm going to start by breaking out the big guns and quoting the one and only Taylor Swift. Can't go wrong with Taylor Swift. So this song came out in 2014, just as I was starting my 5-year residency training in obstetrics and gynecology. It became my mantra. It got me through the difficult days, the rough call shifts, the poor outcomes, the tough criticism from staff. I've sung these words 1,000 times, but I've also learned to live by them. I used to obsess over everything. Every little detail, every little mistake, every little mistake that I thought I made. I wanted to please everyone, and I hated when people didn't like me. Let me tell you, that is an exhausting way to live. And part of growing up is learning what is worth your time and attention and what you can let go. The haters are going to hate. It doesn't matter how good you are at what you do, there will always be someone who doesn't like the way you do it or thinks you could do it better. Sometimes this criticism actually has nothing to do with you. It's their issues and insecurities coming through. If you're able to shake it off, you take away their power and instead give yourself the power to be responsible for your own happiness. However, sometimes this tough love is coming from a person you respect. Someone is giving you guidance on how to grow and better yourself as a person. That is the feedback to listen to take to heart, and try to implement in your life. Number two, couldn't decide what to call this one, so it has two names. Live in the moment and enjoy the journey. This is probably the most important thing I could tell you. At this point in your lives, the world is yours for the taking. You can do anything you want to. And while that's an amazing feeling, The endless potential opportunities can also be overwhelming. It feels like you should have it all figured out, that you should have a plan. And some of you probably do have a plan. And then there are some of you that probably have a very detailed life plan. That was me. I thought I had it all figured out. Undergrad, medical school, residency, find a job, get married, start a family. And having a plan worked out for me, don't get me wrong. And when I take the time to live in the moment, to focus on where I am in life and what I have, I feel blessed to have accomplished these goals. I feel so lucky to get to do what I do every day. Delivering babies is a pretty amazing job. But if I've learned anything in the past 17 years, it would be not to get so caught up in the end goal that you forget to enjoy the journey. It's so easy to always be thinking about that next step that you forget to just enjoy where you're at. Don't rush through life trying to get to that end destination. Time will go quickly enough on its own. Don't wish it away. So many times I remember thinking, life will be so much better. It will be so much easier once I'm finally in medical school, once I'm in residency, once I'm a staff. I just need to get through this. And while there was some truth to that, it turns out that this, whatever stage of life I was at, was pretty great in retrospect. It's like Andy's quote from The Office. I wish there was a way to know you were in the good old days before you've actually left them. If you take nothing else away from this speech, pay attention to this. Enjoy and appreciate every stage of your life. Don't rush through it trying to get to bigger and better things, trying to check off all the goals on your life checklist. Don't miss out on the fun and the joy along the way. And for those of you who don't have a plan yet, that's okay too. You don't need to have the rest of your life decided today. Give yourself the grace to not have it all figured out. Be open to new experiences and see where they take you. Pay attention to what makes you happy and let that guide you. Sometimes we think we know what we want in life, and then we realize we were wrong. Don't be afraid to admit that and make a change. Don't feel like you have to stick with your plan just because it was your original plan. It's never a waste. There is always something to be gained with every experience. Number 3, comparison is the thief of joy. This one has always been a hard one for me. For anyone who knows me, they know that I'm competitive by nature. It's what drives me, and it's what got me through many, many years of school. It's what made me work harder, study longer, but also caused a lot of unnecessary stress and sadness. Letting go of the need to be the best and instead focus on becoming the best version of myself has given me so much freedom. There's always going to be someone who does something better than you, who is smarter, better looking, more athletic, has nicer clothes, whatever it is. There's always going to be someone who you feel has beaten you. And with social media, we are constantly surrounded by perfect images of other people's perfect lives. And while we know that deep down, these cannot be reality, it's hard not to feel inadequate at times. So once again, I urge you to live in the moment and focus on the amazing things in your own life. Appreciate the people and the things in your life that make it worthwhile. Number 4, fake it till you make it. Another one of my mantras. Imposter syndrome, which is defined as the persistent inability to believe one's success is deserved or has been legitimately achieved as a result of one's own efforts or skills. At some point or another, we all feel like imposters. Maybe you feel like this today. You can't believe you're successfully graduating from high school, going away to university, or starting a new job. It's scary, and you feel that there's no way you're prepared for this next step. You feel like you have no idea what you're doing. But everyone else around you seems so calm, so prepared, so smart, so talented. These feelings are normal, and you are not alone. I guarantee you that everyone around you feels the same way. I feel like an imposter right now, standing here in front of all of you, sharing my words of wisdom, when I'm still trying to figure it all out for myself. When I think back to when I was younger, at my own graduation, all the adults seemed to have it all together. Maybe they did, or maybe they were just really good at faking it. You can either let these feelings of inadequacy overwhelm you, or you can power through them. Fake it till you make it. Be confident. It's not luck or coincidence that has gotten you this far. It's your hard work. If you act confident in yourself, soon you will start to feel confident in yourself and your abilities. Just be careful. Don't mistake confidence for cockiness. Know your limitations, respect those who are there to teach you, and you will be just fine. Number 5, treat yourself. This one has a couple different meanings. First of all, it means treat yourself with kindness, treat yourself with respect, treat yourself the way you feel others should treat you. Cut yourself some slack and don't be too hard on yourself. Focus on all the good. It also means taking the time to enjoy the good things in life. This doesn't mean you need to spend a lot of money on fancy things. Just enjoy the little things that make you happy. Spend time with family and friends. Practice self-care. Give yourself some time off from homework or your perpetual to-do list. Watch some mindless TV. Eat some junk food. Whatever it is that brings you joy, indulge. You deserve it. And lastly, number 6, you do you. Let your instincts guide you. Do what you feel is right for you, not what others think you should do. Follow the beat of your own drum, make your own decisions, don't succumb to peer pressure. It can be hard sometimes to stand up in a crowd and do what you feel is right instead of what everyone else is doing. But in the end, you need to be able to hold yourself accountable for your actions and be proud of the choices you've made. We are all very lucky to have gone to Harrison Trimble. There's something very special about this school. It doesn't matter how long I've been gone, the sight of the maroon and white still fills me with pride. I owe a lot to this school. Its teachers taught me a lot of valuable life lessons, and although I don't use calculus much in my everyday life, I do use the skills that I learned in that class: critical thinking, hard work, and perseverance when things don't come easily. Harrison Trimble is where I met some of my best friends. Friends that are still such an important part of my life today. Friends who have known me for 20 years, who have known and loved many different versions of me, and friends who will always be there for me. I can only wish the same for you and the friendships you have created during your time at Trimble. Harrison Trimble is where I first fell in love with my husband. I can't imagine where my life would be if we hadn't met. Trimble is where I learned how much I love to learn, how much I love the sciences, where I decided I wanted to become a doctor. My years at Trimble started me on the journey to become the person I am today. And even if it doesn't feel like it right now, you are all well into your journey to become the person you are meant to be in this world. You may not know exactly what that journey is going to look like or where you're going to end up, but that's okay. The journey is more important than the destination. I wish you all the very best as you start the next chapter of your lives. Congratulations, class of 2023. You've got this.
Do you want to stand on that accent?
Oh.
Read it. Dr. Black, thank you for your thoughtful and motivational words this evening. Hearing these words from a fellow Harrison Trimble graduate is a true honor. I know that when you touched on one of your mantras, which is shake it off, it touched me as well as many other graduates who have difficulty living in the moment and letting things go and just accepting the reality. I also know that you touched many Swifties from our graduating class. Sorry. On behalf of the graduating class of 2023, we would like you to accept... Sorry. Yeah, I don't have my script. I don't know. We have made... On behalf of the graduating class of 2023, we have made a donation in your name to the Friends of the Moncton Hospital for $100 to support their NICU. As we all know, this is a cause near and dear to all of us for Trojans past, present, and future. You are a true example of the motto, once a Trojan, always a Trojan. Thank you.
The valedictorian is chosen by the graduating class to speak on their behalf at the graduation ceremony. It is fitting that this Trojan was chosen to speak at the last official high school event for this class, as he often greeted the graduating class each morning with a signature, "Good morning, grads." As a member of our grad council, Spencer played an integral role in ensuring the year was filled with memories to last a lifetime. No matter what was going on, whether it was stressful or relaxed, he always showed up with a good sense of humor and a relaxed attitude. His approach always put others at ease and made them feel welcomed. It gives me great pleasure to welcome Spencer Hitchcock to the stage as the valedictorian for the class of 2023.
Good evening, honored guests, Trimble administrators and teachers, and most of all, my fellow graduates. It is truly an honor to be given the chance to speak to all of you at such a defining moment in all of our lives. Despite the fact that I am trying to make all of you cry, I do still like most of you. I would like to say before I start that this speech was definitely not written entirely by ChatGPT. And neither is anything else I've handed in, I promise. Also, after my speech is over, I will then read aloud my self-assessment of my speech, which will likely be longer than the speech itself. To start, I would like to thank all of the faculty and staff. None of us would be here if it weren't for your guidance, care, and especially your patience. You all sacrifice your time and put in tremendous effort to ensure each and every one of us an opportunity to succeed in whichever discipline we choose to pursue. We thank you for taking your time out of your evenings to stand around at high school dances, for having to put barricades in front of the school washrooms because students took a brick out of the wall, and for being present here tonight. We all thank you for your dedication, though some of us may have odd ways of showing it. As the grad class of 2023, we had a very unique high school experience. We came to Trimble as nervous kids, reluctant yet ready to start a new chapter in our lives attending high school. Then we stopped attending high school in the middle of our first year. We had the summer break of a lifetime, but not long after it became clear that our high school experience was not going to be quite what we expected. We did come back, kind of. We were here half the time, split into different tracks. Our whole school was divided. Then in grade 11, it was supposed to get better. It wasn't exactly great. But now suddenly we're here, grade 12, the final lap, and now we are at the finish line. We've all heard people say that the 4 years of high school are going to fly by without us noticing. That never quite stuck in the moment. It's hard to believe the time is whisking by when you're 40 minutes into your third period team's call. But now we are graduating, and our time at Harrison Trimble is over. It is important that we look back upon all that we've accomplished together as a grad class. Unbeknownst to us, when we entered high school as grade nines, we had just been given a very large responsibility. We are the last class that experienced true Trojan pride before everything closed, thanks to COVID. And after the world started to reopen, it was our burden to resuscitate the Trojan spirit. We had to unite our student body and become exemplars of what it means to be a Trojan. We had to rebuild the energy and spirit our school is renowned for, be mentors for the students who follow. And the class of 2023 has not only lived up to, but surpassed these expectations. There are so many talented, hardworking, kind, accepting, and devoted students that are graduating tonight. And to be the grad class that heralded the return of school assemblies and dances, raised enormous funds for Trojan Trek and Fill the Bus, and took home multiple provincial banners, it could not have been any other way. We are a diverse group of individuals, with students hailing from different countries across the globe and students spanning from all sides of the economic spectrum, all united as one Trojan family, kids helping kids, pride in ourselves, pride in our school, pride in our community. Even while carrying this responsibility, we've still managed to overcome the obstacles in our path and end up where we are here, right now. These challenges we've overcome are evidence of growth and improvement that we have made since first arriving at Harrison Trimble. And man, do we love evidence of learning here. The grad class of 2023 will be remembered for its ability to persevere, to find hope when all hope seems lost, to take charge and lead by example, to work together, embracing differences, to find strength in unity and use that power to uplift everyone. These are the qualities that we bring to the future and the qualities that we leave behind for the students who follow. But part of moving on is saying goodbye. And given all that we've built together, it may seem hard to leave it behind. We will forever remember everything we have accomplished as a grad class and bring the skills that we have learned out into the world. It is the relationships we formed through the triumphs and struggles we have experienced together that we will reminisce about. Though we may be physically parting, we will forever and always be Trojans, all part of the same Trojan family. I know that every single graduate present here is capable of achieving whatever they wish. I am forever grateful to say that I've spent these four formative years of my life with such open and caring souls. I am forever grateful to say that I was a part of the Harrison Trimble grad class of 2023. Thank you, and good night, grads.
Thank you, Spencer, for your message. Your care and enthusiasm while representing this grad class has been evident all year, and we thank you in advance for the wonderful Trojan ambassador that you will be as you move on to the next stage of your life. I would now like to invite Bethany Barbera to the stage to present the Life Officer Award.
Hello, everyone. The Life Officer Award is presented to a graduate that exemplifies the characteristics of a true Trojan. They show great leadership and are consistently there at most, if not all, school grad events throughout their graduating year. Whether they are lending a hand, volunteering for grad activities, or participating in events themselves, this graduate stands out amongst the others. This award allows us to honor a graduate for consistently being there to support their graduating class. They are the unsung hero of their year at Harrison Trimble. Over the course of our grad year, this recipient we have chosen displayed each of these qualities. Back in September, it was made clear to us that this grad did not want to have any regrets leaving Harrison Trimble and was ready to get involved in any way that they could. This began with our grad sunrise, where this grad got up bright and early to watch the sun come up as a symbol of new beginnings as we begin our final year of high school. As the year progressed, this grad was present at most, if not all, events ran by our grad and student councils. From lunchtime activities to various grad events, this grad could be counted on to be there whenever you needed them to be and giving their 100% effort. Some of these events include breakfasts, bowling, skating, grad fashion show, dragon boat, and hunting for our very own leprechaun at St. Patrick's Day. This grad's participation was second to none. Not only did they show up, but they played an active role in incorporating as many people as possible and making everyone feel welcomed and included. While our recipient certainly stood out as a leader amongst the graduating class, he also had strong motivations and commendable work ethic that did not go unnoticed by any of his fellow classmates or teachers. Despite taking on our school's most challenging courses, such as calculus, AP psychology, and physics, this student maintained impressive honorary marks while consistently showing up and giving it their all, both inside and outside of the classroom. This year, he joined many school sports, such as lacrosse and track and field teams, which both brought home the banner for Trimble at the end of their respective seasons. He is also an active member in our Indigenous community. No doubt, a special memory for him this year was winning our gingerbread house competition back in December. This student's dedication to his school, classes, and fellow peers demonstrates superb leadership qualities and encapsulates the true meaning of being a Trojan. He is, without a doubt, the unsung hero of this year's graduating class. With immense pride, I present the Life Officers Award to Nick Parent.
Thank you, Bethany, and congratulations, Nick. My name is Marcy Keith, and I'm one of the vice principals. Tonight, we are proud to celebrate our diverse Trojan family. As previously mentioned by Mr. Wilson, our 230 graduates represent 32 countries, speaking 23 languages. The post-secondary plans of our graduates range from joining the workforce next year to attending local college programs and universities. We have students traveling across the country and the world. From the University of Calgary to the University of Pennsylvania in Indiana, and even as far as a film school in Ireland. As a class, they have been offered over $655,000 in scholarships and bursaries. No matter your future endeavors, we wish you well on your journey.
Good evening, my name is Shelley Gingeron. I'm very proud to be one of the vice principals here at Harrison Trimble High School. You will notice this evening that some of our students are wearing a little extra regalia with their caps and gowns. These denote two things. Students who received honors are those students who have an average of 85.0% or higher in their top 9 grades from their grade 12 year. To denote this, those students are wearing white cords around their necks. Honors with distinction is designated for those students who finish in the top 10% of the graduating class. These students are wearing both a white and a maroon and white cord. I would ask all of these students to please stand to be acknowledged.
We are about to begin awarding the diplomas. Likely you noted that earlier there had been sections that were cordoned off. This had been done so that our grads can make their way to and from the stage with ease. Because of this, we just ask that you remain seated throughout the process. So just that we're clear, nobody should be running up for hugs and kisses right now, okay? So. We will... begin with the, do you guys want to start? Just as our graduates are lining up tonight, one of our retiring teachers, Lawrence McGilvery, will be honoring our graduates with the tassel turn. And this is normally given to one of our retiring teachers. And we're certainly going to miss you, Lawrence. And I'm glad you could be a part of this tonight. So. Kerrigan Avery Adams, graduate, honors with distinction, the Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250, the Enhanced Entrance Scholarship for Mount Allison University in the amount of $3,000 per year for a total of 12, and the French Immersion Certificate. Christine Iwomazino Agbamouche, graduate with honors. Nidhi Balkrishna Agrawal, graduate with honors, the Thomas H. Dixon Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $250. Abdulrahman Abdo Muhammad Abdo El Sayed Ahmed, graduate, honors with distinction, Major Access Award for Queen's University in the amount of $10,000 per year for a total of $40,000. Moyo Sora Lua Muhammad Ajenafuja, graduate. Karin Akulov, graduate, honors with distinction, the Vicky Lynn Babineau Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $1,000, Student Leadership Scholarship from St. Thomas University in the amount of $2,000 per year for a total of $8,000. Renewable Scholars Scholarship from St. Thomas University in the amount of $2,000 for the first year and $1,000 in subsequent years for a total of $5,000. Millennium Entrance Bursary to St. Thomas University in the amount of $2,000. And the Dennis Cochran Entrance Scholarship to St. Thomas University in the amount of $2,000. Sidra Al Kurdi, graduate. Cameron Sean Wayne Albert, graduate with honors. The Moncton South PC Association Scholarship in the amount of $250. Dominic Leo Allen, graduate. William Stephen Allen, graduate. Grace Princilia Nzanga, graduate. Caleb Gerard John Arbo, graduate. Kyle Edmund Arsenault, graduate. Toba Lua Lache, Sean Ayanwale, graduate with honors. Taryn Maddox Ailes, graduate. Bethany Christina Barbera, graduate, life officer. Avery Rafael Castillo Barrering, graduate. Tristan James Barkos, graduate. Dustin Mark Michael Berry, the Jeff Barnes Memorial Bursary in the amount of $1,000, Male Athlete of the Year, and also a graduate. Sierra Jacqueline Bass, graduate. Raina Bastrash, graduate. The APSE Auxiliary Raymond LeBlanc Bursary in the amount of $100. Sam Bastrash, graduate, absent. Ikram Benoun, graduate. The Jeannie Burke Bursary for Community Service in the amount of $1,000. Bourse d'études post-secondaire en français langue seconde from the University of Moncton in the amount of $3,000. Bourse d'accueil de mairie académique from the University of Moncton in the amount of $1,500. Bourse Ville de Moncton en immersion from the University of Moncton in the amount of $2,500. Bourse immersion français langue seconde from the University of Moncton in the amount of $3,000. Bourse concours d'oratoire from the University of Moncton in the amount of $1,500. And it has received the French immersion certificate. Madison Cody Bernard, graduate. Marie Bernice Bertrand, graduate. Melanie Lydia Betts, graduate with honors, French Immersion Certificate. Aiden Timothy Boleyn, graduate with honors and French Immersion Certificate. Mahima Budeni, graduate. Rye Jacob Bossard, graduate. The Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250. Sorry. Elena Grace Boudreau, graduate with honors. The Magnetic Hill Home and School Memorial Bursary in the amount of $500. The Enhanced Entrance Scholarship from Mount Allison University in the amount of $2,000 per year for a total of $8,000. A Life Officer, an Entrance Bursary from Mount Allison University in the amount of $1,500, and a French Immersion Certificate. Emma Bourdon, graduate, honors with distinction, the HTHS Administrator's Award in the amount of $500. Kaylin Matthew Francis Boyd, graduate, a Focus on Infotech Certificate. Daniel Andrew Briggs, graduate. Carson Douglas Parker Brown, graduate. Colby Maximilian Burns, graduate. Sarah Emily Casey, graduate with honors. Rafael Mateo Calle Espinoza, graduate with honors. Chloe Faith Campbell, graduate with honors, French Immersion Certificate. Ellie Charlotte Post Campbell, graduate with honors, the Crandall Studio Bursary in the amount of $250, the Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250, the Royal Canadian Legion Branch Number 6 Bursary in the amount of $750, the Entrance Scholarship from St. Francis Xavier University in the amount of $1,250 per year for a total of $5,000, an Alumni Endowment Award from St. Francis Xavier University in the amount of $500, and a French Immersion Certificate. Josh David Campbell, graduate, honors, focus on InfoTech certificate. Abigail Faith Carr, graduate, absent. Connor Aaron Carter, graduate, with honors. Board of Governors Langley Entrance Scholarship from Crandall University in the amount of $1,000. President's Leadership and Service Scholarship from Crandall University in the amount of $1,000, focus on InfoTech certificate and a French Immersion certificate. Lok-Ting Clement Chan, graduate, honors with distinction and a distinction award. Ashton Tai Pakwin Como, graduate, focus on InfoTech certificate. Kaylee Brooke Lucy Cormier, graduate, honors, French Immersion certificate. Hunter Philip Daniel Damon, graduate. Anusha Savandave, graduate. Mason Percy Davidson, graduate. Kiera Royan Davis, graduate, absent. Aiden Boyd Francis DeGrucci, graduate, has been gifted the Eagle Feather.
Awesome job, bud.
Nicholas Scott DeLuca, graduate, honors, focus on InfoTech certificate. Grace Michelle Dempsey, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Juan Fernando Diaz Granado Sosa, graduate. Avery Jean Dingy, graduate. Enhanced Entrance Scholarship from Mount Allison University in an amount of $1,000 per year for a total of $4,000. Community Leaders Award from Mount Allison University in the amount of $2,000. Entrance Bursary from Mount Allison University in the amount of $1,500 and a French Immersion Certificate. Sabrina Chantal Doucette, French graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Cheyenne Courtney Lee Eagles, graduate. Tierney Alexandria McKenzie Edgett, graduate with honors, the Ron Smythe Memorial Opportunity Scholarship in the amount of $500, the Ron Smythe Memorial Community Leadership Scholarship in the amount of $1,500, the Friends of the Trojans Bursary in the amount of $500, the Royal Canadian Legion Branch Hillsborough Bursary in the amount of $2,000, the Three Fathers Memorial Run Bursary in the amount of $1,000, the Entrance Award of Merit from the University of Toronto in the amount of $2,000, the Muriel Connors Award in the amount of $500, and the French Immersion Certificate. Aliyah Galtiano El Neymar, graduate with honors. Onyedika Ernest and Willem I. Bianu, graduate. Summer Patricia Essen, graduate, honors with distinction. The Magnetic Hill Home and School Memorial Bursary in the amount of $500. The Magnetic Hill School Staff Bursary in the amount of $500. The Harrison Trimble Administrators Award in the amount of $500. The Knights of Columbus First Bishop Godin Scholarship in the amount of $800 per year for a possible a total of $4,000. The Steve Nixon Memorial Bursary in the amount of $750. Tuition and Athletic Scholarship from the Indiana University of Pennsylvania in the amount of $42,875 for a total of $171,000. And a French Immersion Certificate. Ahmad Fakhouri, graduate. Xavier Michael Farah, graduate. Omar Samir Figuerio Valdez, graduate. Focus on InfoTech certificate and the Arsene O'Brien Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500. Harmony Ocean Fisher, graduate. Noah Alexander Fisher, graduate. Jesse Flanagan, graduate. Madison Christie Flanagan, graduate. Jamie Emma Lee Fleet, graduate. Mariel Krishna Ramirez Flores, graduate with honors. Claire Adelaide Forsyth, graduate with honors, the Royal Canadian Legion Branch Bursary in the amount of $750, the MBIA Ray Legere Excellence Award in the amount of $250, the Friends of the Trojans Bursary in the amount of $500, Entrance Scholarship from the University of Prince Edward Island in the amount of $2,000, Joseph Daly Leaders of Tomorrow Scholarship in the amount of $2,500, and a French Immersion Certificate. Brooklyn Joy Fullerton, graduate, honors. The Friends of the Trojans Bursary in the amount of $500, Female Athlete of the Year, and our French Immersion Certificate.
Leslie Ameline Gagnon Wheaton, graduate, honors, Joyce Foundation Purdy Crawford Bursary from Mount Allison University in the amount of $5,000 per year for a total of $20,000. Enhanced Entrance Scholarship from Mount Allison University for $3,000 per year for a total of $12,000. Entrance Bursary from Mount Allison University in the amount of $1,500, French Immersion Certificate. Brianna Elizabeth Gallant, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Keila Joyce Gallant, graduate, honors. Liam Christopher Gallant, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Lisa Gandhi, graduate, honors, L.A. and Upham Edith Scholarship from Dalhousie University in the amount of $5,000 per year for a total of $20,000. Global Scholar Award from Dalhousie University in the amount of $5,000 per year for a total of $20,000. Renewable Bursary from Dalhousie University in the amount of $1,200 per in years 1 and 2, $1,600 in years 3 and 4 for a total of $5,600. Gianna Angel Alicia Gardner, graduate. Makai Albert Godreau, graduate. Bianca Madeline Gibson, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Corbin James Gibson, graduate. Marley Hayden Gilbert, graduate, honors, the Birchmount Home and School Award in the amount of $500, French Immersion Certificate. Brooklyn Diane Joan Gilroy, graduate. Logan Alexander Gerard, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Sophie Claire Gordon, graduate. Jordan Raymond James Gauchy, graduate. Yeah. Jesse Green, graduate. Kayla Pamela Hamilton, graduate. Kudzai Nathaniel Hammond, graduate, absent. Olivia Paige Hannum, graduate, honors. The DNA Swag Ladies Hoop Classic Bursary in the amount of $500. Maroon Heart Award, French Immersion Certificate. Kennedy K. Ann Harris, graduate. Alice Hart Tower, graduate. Elizabeth Lee Henwood, graduate, honors. The Ron Smythe Memorial Community Leadership Scholarship in the amount of $1,500. UNB Good Energy Scholarship from the University of New Brunswick in the amount of $10,000 per year for a total of $40,000. French Immersion Certificate. Elijah Kent Ayad Herosa, graduate, honors with distinction. Harris Oscar Higgins, graduate, honors with distinction. The Medivie Community Leadership and Academic Scholarship in the amount of $2,000. The Omista Credit Union Bursary in the amount of $500. The Engineering Award of Excellence from McMaster University in the amount of $3,000. Spencer James Hitchcock, graduate, honors with distinction, valedictorian. Renewable Entrance Scholarship from Dalhousie University in the amount of $4,000 per year for a total of $16,000. Future Technology Leader Scholarship from Dalhousie University in the amount of $3,000. Life Officer, French Immersion Certificate. Jacob Michael House, honors with distinction, graduate. Portia Janine Howe, graduate, honors. Zin Min Tet, graduate. Bryce James Rick Hunter, graduate. The Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250. The HTHS Administrators Award in the amount of $500. The Magnetic Hills School Staff Bursary in the amount of $500. The Sonny McClellan Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $1,000. Entrance Scholarship from the University of New Brunswick in the amount of $500. French Immersion Certificate. Kai Tran Huynh, graduate, honors with distinction. International Entrance Award from the University of Calgary in the amount of $20,000. President's Admission Scholarship from the University of Calgary in the amount of $5,000. Fernando Ibera Martinez, graduate honors. Connor James Ingebrigtsen, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Sadie Dawn Jones Guthrow, graduate. Gregory Alexander Kierstead, graduate, absent. Keith Anthony Kierstead, graduate, absent. Christopher James Daniel Keller, graduate. Jack Wyatt Kelly, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Ali Ahmed Khan, graduate. Ibrahim Khan, graduate, Focus on Information Technology Certificate. Aiden James Ray Murray King, graduate. Ariana Amanda Knowles, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. James Robert Jordan Cowan, graduate, honors, the Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250, French Immersion Certificate. Maxim Kremarenko, graduate. Sua Kwan, graduate, honors. Kevin Charles Roger LaForêt, graduate, absent. Kayla Landry, graduate, absent. Sally Alexandra Langell Peacock, graduate. Haley Caitlin Lebens, graduate. Austin Jason Joseph LeBlanc Fournier, graduate. Caleb Allen LeBlanc, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Carly Sarah LeBlanc, graduate. Keegan Philip Jason LeBurk, graduate. Focus on Information Technology certificate, has been gifted the Eagle Feather. Jackson Philip Leach, graduate. Savannah Lynn Legier, graduate. Amy Lemon, graduate, honors with distinction, French immersion certificate. Jiayu Lee, graduate, honors with distinction, the James Roberts Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $1,500, the Lauren Finalist Award in the amount of $5,000, the Schulich Leader Certificate of Achievement, the CST Foundation Bursary in the amount of $6,000, the Faculty of Applied Science and Engineering Scholarship in the amount of $5,000. Charity Dove Lorette, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Carol Christopher Diego Lucero, graduate, honors. Sabrina Hallie McLean, graduate, honors. Courtney Ann Maillard, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. JC Grace Malley, graduate, honors, the Rockets Bursary Essay in the amount of $500, French Immersion Certificate. Logan Alexander William Malley, graduate. Addison Jane Martin, graduate. Zainab Mamawa Masakwai, graduate. Michael Harding Matthews, graduate, Focus on Information Technology Certificate, French Immersion Certificate. Quinlan Peter Kingsley McDermott, graduate. Rory Raymond Egan McDermott, graduate, absent. Emma Marie McGill, graduate. Sean Edward Thomas McGinley, graduate. Tyler Jordan McKenzie, graduate. Emily Grace McKillop, graduate, honors the HTHS Administrator's Award in the amount of $500, the Omista Credit Union Bursary in the amount of $500, entrance scholarship from St. Francis Xavier University in the amount of $1,250 per year for a total of $5,000, the MBTA Branch 0215 Bursary in the amount of $250. Hannah Catherine Mills, graduate. The Royal Canadian Legion Branch No. 6 Bursary in the amount of $750. French Immersion Certificate. Noah Jackson Mullins, graduate. French Immersion Certificate. Pablo Andre Montenegro Jimenez, graduate. Sarah Lynn Moore, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Connor Clayton Morin, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Ethan John Morrison, graduate, the Friends of the Trojans Bursary in the amount of $500, French Immersion Certificate. Mark Douglas Mosier, graduate, Focus on Information Technology Certificate. Alex Morley Joseph Murray, graduate.
Delando Cleveland Nogler, graduate. Caleb Andrew Gordon Nelson, graduate. Ethan Edward Nelson, graduate, absent. Angus Cole Nickerson, graduate, honors, the Maroon Heart Award, Distinction Award, French Immersion Certificate. Anastasia Nikitaeva, graduate, honors with distinction. Royce Angel Inkaho, graduate. Jack Rylan Oblinas, graduate. Rain Evan Louise O'Brien, graduate. Honors, the Judy Votor Leadership Award, the Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250, the Three Fathers Memorial Run Bursary in the amount of $1,000, the Royal Canadian Legion Branch No. 6 Bursary in the amount of $750, Enhanced Entrance Scholarship from Mount Allison University in the amount of $4,000 per year for a total of $16,000, Distinction Award. Angel Oshignia Oshigbo, graduate. Olua Tofaradi Taiwo Olufin, graduate. Honors with distinction, the Harrison Trimble High School Administrator's Award in the amount of $500. Olua Tofahinti Kehinde Olufin, graduate, honors with distinction, the Friends of the Trojans bursary in the amount of $500. Ebonolua Iniola Oloye, graduate. Renewable bursary for Dalhousie University in the amount of $1,200 in years 1 and 2 and $1,600 in years 3 and 4 for a total of $5,600. Lauren Grace Page, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Alexander William Paradowski, graduate. Nicholas Lawrence Parent, graduate, honors, has been gifted the Eagle Feather Life Officer Award. Jesse Paul Pellerin, graduate. Oliver Peters, graduate. Nathan Gregory Petrie, graduate. Absent. Bianca Mariana Pizarro Pena, graduate, honors. William Reginald Gill Posh, graduate.
Nurhan Fira Rad, graduate, honors. The Crystal Jewett Memorial Bursary in the amount of $500. The Canadian Federation of University Women Moncton University Educational Award in the amount of $1,500. Entrance scholarship from Dalhousie University in the amount of $1,500. Focus on information technology certificate. Alexandria Francis Dawn Reith, graduate, honors, admission scholarship from University of Ottawa in the amount of $1,000. Connor John Reith, graduate, honors with distinction. The Ron Smythe Memorial Community Leadership Scholarship in the amount of $1,500. The MBIAA William S. Ritchie Excellence Award in the amount of $500. The MBIAA Raymond Legere Excellence Award in the amount of $250. The Harrison Trimble High School Student Council Award in the amount of $250. The Harrison Trimble High School Administrators Award in the amount of $500. Entrance scholarship from the University of New Brunswick in the amount of $1,000. The Northrop Frye Home and School Bursary in the amount of $500. The MBTA Branch 0215 Bursary in the amount of $250. Distinction Award, Trojan of the Year. Hannah May Ann Regular, graduate, honors with distinction. The Harrison Trimble High School Staff Award in the amount of $500. The Magnetic Hill School Staff Bursary in the amount of $500. French Immersion Certificate. Taya Mackenzie Remington, graduate, honors. Renewable Entrance Scholarship from St. Mary's University in the amount of $2,000 per year for a total of $8,000. French Immersion Certificate. Delia Aaron May Renton, graduate, honors, the Coulter Award for Literary Excellence, French Immersion Certificate. Alyssa Richard, graduate, honors, Bourse d'études postsecondaires en français langue seconde from the Université de Moncton in the amount of $3,000. Bourse d'immersion français langue seconde from the Université de Moncton in the amount of $3,000. Bourse d'école de mérite académique from the Université de Moncton in the amount of $1,000. French immersion certificate. Dyron Silas Sterling Richard, graduate. Ty Jason Lloyd Richard, graduate. Cody Ann Roberts, graduate. Emily Ann Robertson, graduate. Rachel Lee Robinson, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Alexander James Rogers, graduate. Carl Nathan Roman, graduate. Alex James Ryan, graduate, honors with distinction, the Harrison Trimble High School Administrators Award in the amount of $500, the Three Fathers Memorial Run Bursary in the amount of $1,000, President's Scholarship for St. Thomas University in the amount of more than $32,000 over 4 years. French Immersion Certificate. Cameron Philip Salage, graduate, honors with distinction, the Harrison Trimble High School Staff Award in the amount of $500, Entrance Renewable Scholarship for Dalhousie University in the amount of $3,000 per year for a total of $12,000, Entrance Community and Leadership Award for Dalhousie University in the amount of $1,000, French Immersion Certificate, Life Officer. Raymond Francis Villafania Santos, graduate. Taylor Caitlin Savory, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Yowan Sa, graduate. Gabriel Campo Serrano, graduate, honors, entrance scholarship from the University of New Brunswick for the amount of $2,600, focus on information technology certificate. Sarah Shabanali, graduate, honors with distinction, entrance scholarship for the University of New Brunswick in the amount of $4,000. Fouad Ali Sheikh, graduate, honors. Siokbin Shin, graduate. Filippo Shagonia Nasambwa, graduate. Emma Caitlin Simpson, graduate. Emma Jean Smith, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Isaac Gregory Joseph Smith, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Alex Joshua Snyder, graduate. Jonas Sojahin, graduate, honors. Michael So, graduate. Olivia Mary Catherine Spencer, graduate. Madison Jeanette St. Amand, graduate, honors. Maya Sharon Steves, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Mackenzie Lauren Stretch, graduate, absent. Holly Laura Sturge, graduate, honors with distinction. Evan William Steimeist, graduate, Focus on Information Technology Certificate, French Immersion Certificate. Tianyi Sun, graduate, honors with distinction. Scholarship of distinction from Western University in the amount of $2,500 in the first year and $1,000 in the next year for a total of $3,500. Abigail Lorraine Swetnam, graduate, Bourse d'accueil de mérite académique from the Université de Moncton in the amount of $1,000. Bourse d'études postsecondaires en français langue seconde from the Université de Moncton in the amount of $3,000. French Immersion Certificate. Ryuxi Tan, graduate, honors. Miranda Lee Terrio, graduate, honors, absent. Hannah Grace Thompson, graduate, honors. Sarah Rose Ann Evelyn Turcott, graduate. Angel Umutomi, graduate. Elzaveta Vakula, graduate, absent. Iria Valino Itumendi, graduate. Anna Maria Noella Van Domlin, graduate, honors. Matai Dennis Votor, graduate, honors, the Ron Smythe Memorial Community Leadership Scholarship in the amount of $1,500. the New Brunswick Public College Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $1,000, French Immersion Certificate. Sarah Grace Vickers, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Eric Montgomery Vi, graduate, French Immersion Certificate. Sydney Essie Faith Walker, graduate, honors, the Jeff Barnes Memorial Bursary in the amount of $1,000, French Immersion Certificate. Connor Lee Wallace, graduate. Nalani Edria Racine Walters, graduate, honors. Karis Emma Williams, graduate, honors, French Immersion Certificate. Hope Beverly Wilson, graduate. Connor Michael Wood, graduate. Callie Madeline Woodworth, graduate. Honors with distinction. Stephen and Ella Steve Scholarship from Crandall University for the amount of $2,000. Board of Governors LG Entrance Scholarship from Crandall University in the amount of $1,500. Vice Chancellor's Leadership and Service Scholarship from Crandall University in the amount of $1,250. Athletic Scholarship from Crandall University in the amount of $3,500. French Immersion Certificate. Hancheng Yu, graduate, honors. Quinn Grace Ann Young, graduate, honors with distinction, the Historian Award. French Immersion Certificate. Akin Yurekli, graduate. Honors with distinction. Focus on Information Technology Certificate. Global Scholar Award from Dalhousie University in the amount of $5,000 per year for a total of $20,000. Renewable Bursary from Dalhousie University in the amount of $1,200 in years 1 and 2 and $1,600 in years 3 and 4 for a total of $5,600. Entrance Scholarship from Dalhousie University in the amount of $2,000. Marina Zagrabelna, graduate, absent. Please join me in congratulating the graduating class of 2023. We have two final awards to give out, and I ask that when the recipients' names are called, that they do come to the stage. First is our Burks Medal. The Burks Medal is provided by Henry Burks & Son Maritime Limited and is awarded to the student who has shown most leadership in student affairs during his or her graduating class. The 2023 Burks Medal is being awarded to Ellie Campbell. The second award is our Governor General Medal. The Governor General's Academic Medal was first awarded in 1873 by the Earl of Dufferin and has since become one of the most prestigious awards that a student in Canadian educational institution can receive. The Governor General of Canada continues this tradition of encouraging scholarship across the nation and recognizing outstanding students. The Governor General Medal in secondary schools is awarded to the student with the highest academic average in grade 11 and 12 courses of the graduating class. The 2023 Governor General Medal is being awarded to Lok Ting Clemen Chan.
Almost done. Stay loose. There you go. Yeah, you should have saw it in 82. It was great. So, in closing, I'd like to thank you, our wonderful teachers, administrative assistants, and EAs for putting together this huge event. It takes so much time and energy done so quickly. I really appreciate it. To the graduates, we love you. You'll be missed. You said it. Thanks, Mom. we'll miss you for sure. Right now, I'd like to invite the band up. Our grads will sing the school song, which will be followed by the graduates exiting the auditorium. I'd kindly ask that everybody stay in their seats until the recessional is complete. The graduates and the teachers have left the room. Thank you for coming, and good night.